want to just add my welcome. Thank you so much for being here. This is the largest attended concert we've been able to give in over 3 years. So thank you so much for being here. We're still singing with masks for this concert, but we hope it will be the last one. We've voted to go ahead and start rehearsals in January without masks, and we hope that things will stay such that we can do that, but we're just being safe, and we found that it actually helps us listen better to each other. It's been quite a journey, though. I wanted to also introduce the composer of the next piece, who is with us, Richard Wargo. Richard, where are you? There, just over there. Richard is a resident of Scranton, a long time, and way back in 1988 was commissioned by Alma Heckler to write this piece, and it had a few performances then, but it stayed in the vault until we brought it back to life. Richard went on to become quite a prominent opera composer in the United States. He was introduced to the Choral Society through his sister, who sang with the Choral Society and is here today, along with other members of his family. And there are three members of the choir who sang in that original 1988 performance and are with us today. And one of them, Cheryl Stitzinger, will be singing a solo at the beginning of the eighth movement. And why that's significant is she was the original soloist in the fifth movement, the Lullaby, which is an extended solo for soprano. And we're very pleased that she's passing the baton today to young Grace Herron, who sang with us last year and this year is a graduate student at the Peabody Conservatory. So it's a very special connection for us to our past, to life of music in Pennsylvania, and we hope you enjoy this very special piece, Voices in the Mist.
Thank you. Children, see him on the night. With dark and heavy hair. So children, see him on the night. With this spirit of yellow.
So we hope you enjoyed that little mid-concert encore. Not in your program, but we added it because there was a recent story in NPR that you may have heard how 1922, 100 years ago, was when that piece was first sung in the United States by the Ukrainian National Choir at a time where they were trying to assert their independent cultural identity and hope that the United States would support it. Now we have... We happen to have a few members of the choir of Ukrainian descent, first generation as well as beyond. And this piece became most beloved with these English words in this country, Carol of the Bells, as a Christmas song a few years after it was first sung as Shchedrik at that concert in New York. It was a folk song at the time, but from a culture that had a very strong choral tradition. So we're very happy to add it to our program. Our next part of the program is we do the same thing every year. We sing O Come All Ye Faithful to bring in the rest of the choir to join the chamber choir, and then we sing the Hallelujah Chorus. We invite you to sing along with O Come All Ye Faithful, to stand at the last verse, and to remain standing just in case the new king or second in line happens to appear. We don't know. As the prince was here just a week ago.
Oh,
These next two pieces, this will come on in a second. These next two pieces are ones that I performed with this choir for the first time for myself in the year 2000, my first Christmas concerts with this choir. I wanted something that was about Pennsylvania, because this choir had a very strong sense of place in Bucks County, in Pennsylvania, going back to colonial times. And somebody said, you ought to look into Fred Waring and the Pennsylvanians. Now, you've probably heard of Lawrence Welk, and Lawrence Welk had a longer run for sure. They both started back in the 50s, but what was distinctive about Fred Waring was the choir. It was all about the choir. And some of the arrangements that he did at those times have endured to this day. And two of my favorites, and I'm often teased about them, are Little Drummer Boy and Twas the Night Before Christmas.
Wrong. nose like a cherry, all wrinkled with fun.
His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow,
and the beard on his chin was as white as the snow.